What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Grand Tactician Civil War 1861-1865. Hopefully you guys are doing good today, staying motivated, hydrated, because as we're getting closer to summer, it's going to become a factor. Let's see where we last left off. I think I was doubling up my Union Army, because believe it or not, the Confederacy actually has more troops than me, which is very weird. I'm going to try to put the boys in General Breckinridge. Oh, the Virginia Military Academy. That is based actually, there's actually a movie about this, the Battle of New Market. Field of Lost Shoes. I do recommend that. It's really good. It's kind of like, I don't know if you guys ever saw the movie with, oh my gosh, what was that movie with the kids and the... Oh my gosh, I forgot the daggone name of the movie. Anyway, it's about kids in a Virginia military academy. It's like teenagers and boys, and the war is going on, and they're actually called to combat. And I didn't know that the Confederacy used boys and teenagers in a battle until I actually saw the movie, and the movie was actually good. Unlike, you know, the movie Generals Guz and Generals with, you know, the precursor to Gettysburg. That movie was very political and try to do that states' rights thing. This movie doesn't. It just tells you, like, from what I understand, the facts. But it was a while ago since I saw that movie anyway, so could be wrong. It's not a movie that I watched multiple times, although it does have a good cast in it. All right, so I got my Cav coming up. I got him moving up there. I forgot what battle this was. It's been like a couple of days since I got into the, since I actually played a game. Just, you know, a whole bunch of stuff going on in life. Trying to still find that job, you know. I have an interview Wednesday, the second part of interview. I passed the first part, got through that selection process. It's basically for the same job that I have. It's a IT technician. I'm hoping to get it. Very much hoping to get it. You know what? I could put my boys here and use this as cover. Yeah, let's do that. The other thing I was thinking of doing is if I can't get a position soon, go back to school. I was thinking about doing that. Hopefully, you know, the one thing that I really love that the government does is, you know, you have the loans and grants. The loan's going to kill me, though, in the end. That's the thing that I'm worried about. You know, you can't go to school for too long because, man, that interest piles up. Every time I look at it, like, that I have to pay it off, I'm like, oh, man, this is a... And then I'm going to have to increase that. It's just going to be scary. Oh, man. My buddy was, my friend Yanni. Him and his wife were from Greece. They're in the States now. They were like, I was like, how much do you owe since you both have bachelor's degrees? And I said something like, I'm assuming you guys have a lot similar debt. And they were like, no, we don't actually have anything. And I'm like, you have a bachelor's degree, right? He's like, yeah. I was like, did you pay out of pocket for college? They said, no. I'm like, they were like, the government pays you, for, you know, covers the tuition and stuff. I'm like, that doesn't make sense. It's like, yeah. And they also give you a laptop, like, I think like $1,000 for a laptop. I'm like, what? And he was like, yeah, he says, we don't owe anything. I said, how does that work? He said, in Europe, in a lot of countries in Europe, basically, they just increase the taxes on the rich to facilitate these kind of programs. I was like, oh, he says, you guys don't do that here? I'm like, no, the rich don't pay for anything here. Yeah, they don't pay for jack. He was just like, really? I said, yeah. I mean, heck, you know, if you, I tell him, like, you know, I sent him a couple articles, like in the last couple of years and stuff like that. Like, Amazon got away with not paying a single dime in taxes. I forgot what year it was, 2021 or something like that. And a couple of companies, a number of Fortune 500 companies got away with not paying a single dime in taxes. I think there was even one that got money back, which is kind of crazy. I remember talking about it after reading an article, because I was just like, so my friend, I was just like, dude, I pay more money in taxes than Amazon in regards to the taxes. And he was just like, damn, dude. I was like, yeah. And I mean, it's just, I'm not faulting Amazon or these companies, these Fortune 500 companies. Maybe a little, but I mean, the laws are there. They have the lawyers to find the loopholes, and the loopholes are there, so they just, do it, So, let me built up right around here, so I could probably come up here. And I'll check the chat every couple of minutes. So if I don't get to your, if you guys say anything in the chat, I'll try to get to it as quick as possible. It's just, I like focusing on the battle, and I have so many millions of calculations going on in my head trying to figure out how to fight properly. Harper's Ferry. I forgot what units these are. Is this the Grand Army of the Republic? That army? I forgot which one it is. Army of the Northwest. Yeah, so this is that one. Okay. So this is him coming back from West Virginia. You would have thought the AI would have left a couple of troops in West Virginia. So now that I have McClellan head back to Ohio as this rebel army headed to West Virginia. So they took over West Virginia, and now they're heading back to Maryland, which is what this battle is. And now McClellan's heading back to West Virginia. And I was just thinking in my head, I'm like, was that whole freaking campaign that you just did was pointless? You could have kept like 4,000 men there to keep West Virginia. Now you're gonna lose it. Oh, my phone's out of power. So I was thinking about, found out some news this week. So this was gonna be, if you guys have an iPhone, this was gonna be big WWDC, which is the Apple event that happens every June. And they announce like all the new features come to the iPhone, iPad, Mac, and such. So this was gonna be a big one. A big, massive event. Rumors were that Apple is going to open up the iPhone and iPad. And what that means is you don't have to go to the App Store anymore to get your apps, right? What you could do is you can go on the internet, right? There's sites like GitHub where there's like a repository of literally thousands of applications. They're free. You could download it right now. There's tons of them for everything you can think of. And you could download these apps to your iPhone and not have to go through the App Store. And the reason why this was going to be a big thing was because, I don't know if you guys noticed, but everything in the App Store is becoming a subscription model. So like, I was trying to get like a gym app, like I mentioned previous videos, where I just wanted to catalog, like, all right, I did this many push-ups today, the next day, this how many push-ups I did, just to see how I'm going and have charts and all that stuff. So I did find a number of them. All subscription, right? We're talking like, I think it was like $7 or $8 a month. $7 a month to type in this is how many push-ups I did, and for them to make a chart for that. Now, I have some programming experience. I could make an app like that, and but I just don't I don't want to. It's gonna take a couple weeks, right? And I'm fine with spending a couple dollars, five, ten, whatever, right? I'm fine with doing that. I'm not saying I'm not against giving money, right? But $7, seven times what? That's 77. Looking at what is it? 84? Yeah, 84, right? I think it's maybe my math's wrong. I don't know. $84 a year for this app per year, right? Just to write this stuff down. And it's getting ridiculous. Like they're getting crazy about all these things. You have a gym app like that, then you have like a calorie tracking app where you have to do another $10 a month, and then you have an app to do PDFs, to edit PDFs, that's another $10 a month. I mean, like, it's ridiculous. Like, I understand some developers are like, well, this is gonna help us out to continuously improve the app. I wasn't born yesterday. Like, come on. This whole process of software getting better has been going around since the bloody 70s, right? That's why you had Microsoft Office, 90, 1990, 1992, Microsoft Office 95, iWork, iWork 2, iWork 3. You have versions of software, and Microsoft will come out with Microsoft Office 98, and you're like, oh wow, I have 95, but this has a couple of cool features that I need. Let me buy that, right? So it's been going on. So this whole thing that developers are doing, where like, oh well, we gotta continuously support the product. Don't give me bullshit, okay? Don't try to play us as fools, okay? So yeah, that stuff honestly really bothers me. Because they try to get away with like absolute murder with this kind of stuff. Let me move my guys here because I got a lot of. So yeah, I mean that kind of stuff is ridiculous. And to charge like, I mean if it was like $1 per month, I would probably be like, all right, I don't care, it's $1 a month, right? And eventually, I'll be like, whatever. But to do seven, $10 an hour, $10 a month, right? To compete with the same price of Netflix that offers you, I don't know, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of movies and TV shows. Do you feel like the value is on par? No, it's not. You made an app where I type in stuff and make a chart out of it, right? You do it once and that's it. Versus like a competitor like Netflix that does the same price per month for a subscription, I get access to tens of thousands of movies and TV shows and all this new content that's constantly popping up on the thing, and you're saying it's the same value, and it just gets me pissed off. So Apple is going to open up the iPhone and the apps, and you don't have to rely on the App Store anymore. So these developers are going to be like, oh snap, now we have some serious competition. I know they're gonna be somewhere right there, so we're gonna form up. And I was really excited about it. I was like, all right, finally, finally. Now we can get some free and open source apps made by good people, honest people, right? Apps that do the same exact thing, but guess what? They are free. Free and open source. It's called FOSS, FOSS, right? And yeah, you could just get the app and it'll do it, and you don't have to pay anything. It's free. Of course, I always give open source developers a couple of bucks, like five or maybe $10 of like, hey, OBS is a good one. So this software right here, this is free, OBS, and it does a lot. It's really incredible. You can see this is a new feature that they added. So I donate to them as a thank you for doing it. You don't have to, I do, right? Because yeah, so hold on, let me just. What the heck is this? There's some firing going on. They're firing at my. So yeah, that's what's going on. So I was really excited about it. It was in, there have been rumors that Apple is going to open it up, and as we get closer to June, the rumors just got heavier and heavier. Like, yeah, this is what's going to happen. And then news popped up, not official news. Now, this is all rumors and speculation, but it's by sources that have people inside Apple. The iPhone and iPad will be opened up to open source to apps that you could download from the internet. But only for Europe. And why is that? Is because Europe made this called a Digital Market Rights Act, something like that, last year, which basically means that it's basically an anti-competitive behavior. You can't just have one app store and you control it and all this stuff. I want to see how close I can get before. He's still standing there. Yeah, so let me see if I can. But yeah, so Europe passed this law last year, and it affects Apple, Google, and a lot of the other manufacturers, and they have to like open up the app stores and stuff like that. They can't be like monopolize the whole thing. This is another reason why the iPhone's getting USB-C and it's replacing Lightning. Europe wants one connector for everything. So like every electronic product has one cable, no more proprietary stuff. You know, you can literally grab your buddy's cable, plug it into your phone, stuff like that. And you know, there are pros and cons to either or. Like I got tons of Lightning cables now. They're going to be useless with the iPhone 15, which is fine. Okay, keep going. Yeah, so tons of so you're gonna have all that stuff going on. Now, we're not getting it because we did have legislation similar to the European legislation, but you know, the way our Congress and our legislators are going, they're having a hard time agreeing on, well, anything. So it got stalled up and hasn't been addressed since. So maybe 2024, hopefully 2025. Damn. So hopefully maybe one of those years they'll push that, but so we're not gonna get it, which really sucks because you know I was hoping it would change stuff, man. Like I'm tired of paying like all this. Everybody's, yeah, no offense. And I don't want to, you know, some people watching this might be business owners, and I'm not saying it's you, right? I'm just saying there's a lot of businesses, corporations especially, that are becoming greedy. Greedy, right? And it goes from small developers all the way to big corporations, but they are getting greedy, man, at a time when, like, people don't have that much reserve cash, you know? Or any reserve cash in some aspects, you know? Jobs are getting worse. I forgot what. Was it Lyft? One of the popular ride sharing or food services just fired a third of their force a couple of days ago. So you know, things are getting worse and worse, man. Even like I was saying, like my company laid off everybody, and I got through the first round. I knew I wasn't gonna get through the second round because the second round was gonna be, from what the guy told me, 90% of the company. I was like, oh, well, I'm probably not gonna get past that one. He was like, no. That is what it is, you know? I was really hoping for that stuff. You know, I was really hoping for the open source because I was like, man, if that happens, I'm getting an iPhone 15. Probably can't. I probably shouldn't since I'm unemployed, but hopefully I find a job by the time it comes out in September. iPhones usually come out like literally every year since in September since 2011. So it's a good chance this year. It's usually in the second week of September. Oh, crap, they found me. I don't know how, but they found me. Run for it, Marty! Who do you think? The Libyans! What the heck? Come on. There we go. Oh, that's why. I was pressing the wrong bloody button. There you go. And then once this artillery guy, oh, I need you up here. I'll put you right alongside. I think this is a good plan. What do you guys think? So I'm gonna have two divisions, right, back to back, line up here. We're gonna, this is, I think, should be good because I'll have some cover coming up here, and then when I come up here, my gosh, they took the slope. That was a bad idea for them. I'll be on top. My guns are firing. They're very tired. Keep firing, boys. Keep firing. Oh, they're moving their infantry in. Let me double time my boys. Come on. Man, I forgot how long stuff takes in, this time period for units to like get where they're going, to be all coordinated. It takes a little bit. So yeah, since Apple is not doing that, I mean, we don't know, but strong rumors are they're not going to include US. It's just going to be Europe. Oh wow, they're all moving forward. I guess they're taking the top ridge. Now they're smart. Yeah, now they're smart. Dang. All right. Whatever. But so I was thinking of, I'm not going to switch to Android. I'm thinking about getting like a Linux phone. I know I mentioned this in the past, but like I'm getting tired of like all the, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm getting tired of all the privacy stuff. I know Apple is big into privacy, but I know there's a lot of data coming out of the iPhone going to Apple. There was one YouTube video that found out that every time you go into the App Store or iTunes Store or like iBook Store, every time you go into those stores, everything you click, everything you move gets sent to Apple. Like literally everything you do in that, inside those apps. And I don't know, it just bothers me. Like, it's my phone. Like, I want complete privacy, right? Like, I don't want you to know, like, that I clicked on this app to see what it's about, Like, I want privacy in my devices, Some people are going to be like, well, you got something to hide? I'm like, no, I just want privacy. Like, good example is like your home, right? This is a room that I sleep in, right? I have shades to get some privacy. It's the same thing, Phone is actually even more private than your dwelling because you got, you take photos, your loved ones, you have pictures in there, videos, passwords, all this stuff there, Do you think they took this and then they decided to abandon it? That would be stupid. Got two artillery batteries opening up on them. I need one to do counter battery fire, so knock out their artillery. This is pretty good. This is pretty good. I'm doing good, I think. Lads. Move third division up here. Don't have any more troops in reserve, do I? What the heck is seventh division? Oh, shoot. I think that's about it. I ran into when I was still working. Wow, it sounded like glass was breaking. That was pretty cool. Oh, that was a nice animation. So the developers actually coded that. So I'm assuming based on the code, they've said, all right, if there's a house there and cannons are dropping, initiate like glass breaking sound. Oh, you're idle. Why you're idle? Oh, crap. Oh, because they're now. Psycho killer. Psycho killer. Doo, doo, doo. Keep firing, boys. Keep them down. All right, so it looks like I took one objective. They took it and they decided to withdraw from it, which is weird. All right, the AI is not that smart, and I'll tell you why. They put their back against the river. Like, I wouldn't have done that. So now, what I could do technically is I could move my whole division. And maybe I should actually do that. I'm gonna do something like that. So this way I can kind of corner them. My boys are nice and tight. Oh, that's why. My bad. I hear rifle firing. Oh, they brought up a brigade. They're still coming? Yeah, they're still coming. I got no losses on these guys. Reform! Pour it into them boys! Hit them on their flanks! And I got the Mississippi rifles on this guy. They're gonna get slaughtered. And Greg's in contact too. Beautiful. Love it. Right, so we're engaging. They're sending some kind of probing attack. I'm gonna have you double time. So this way, this division, 6th division, can take positions here. Then I got another division, 3rd division right behind that. I think this time we're gonna win, boys. I think we're gonna whoop them. Whip them, whip them. Getting tighter. They're moving another brigade forward. I said double quick. Why are you just sitting there, dude? Where's the cavalry going? They're putting a 3rd brigade in, 4th brigade, 5th brigade. They're throwing the met the a whole lot of them in. All right, you need to double quick your boys. 3rd division, double quick your boys. Tell them move faster. We don't have time. Dude, you gotta move in there. Oh, my artillery's taking a heavy hit. They're not doing well. Winfield Scott Hancock is in charge of. Why that? Why would the AI put an infantry officer in charge of cannon? Seriously? I need to fix that. I'm gonna move the third division up here. Oh crap, now I know why. Because that's part of third. Alright, so since they are doing this, we're gonna start marching in. We're gonna use the slope as protection against that artillery. My general. Double time. Come on, guys. Double time. Wonder how many losses. 50? This can't be right. He lost 50 men, because I got muskets. I wonder what freaking rifles he has. I wonder if it's a musket or. See if we can move there. Hi, sweetie. Yeah, he's moving his some of his soldiers. He sees me moving up. Let's issue some skirmishers. Skirmishes! Forward! While I have a whole division gonna cut them off. Should have had Stonewall lead your boys. They're not doing so well. Do me a favor, head to the extreme left flank. I think we're good. I'll have third division support as like reserve kind of thing. Dang it, man. Keep forgetting you're in that. Get closer in. We're hitting our artillery, right? No casualties yet on that. Got 200 men here, 187 there. And we're firing up a storm here. Sylvester Churchill, I never heard of that guy. Are they firing at me? No, they're firing west. Okay. I want you to redirect there. Ooh, we're in the thick of it, boy. Like, look at all that smoke. Come on, go here. Double time. Oh, these guys. Let me see if I can get cavalry charge that freaking. Double time. I want to see if I get. I don't want to throw infantry or artillery, man. I know it can be done and I should charge their rounds, but they got two brigades there. I'd rather fire it at it. Still want to see whole masses of my men just dropped, you know? Because the one cool thing about this game is, like, and this is what happens in, like, Victoria 2, is, oh crap, he's taking heavy losses here. About a quarter of his force. Is if you lose soldiers on the battlefield, right? It affects. It just doesn't affect the war. It affects everything, right? So the soldiers you recruit or volunteer or draft from states, right, reduces the industry output of those states. So these men are vital, right? Like they're not cannon. They're not cannon fodder, you know? Like I need them. This is the third time I'm issuing this freaking order. He doesn't listen. Like, if they go KIA, right, then. If they go KIA, then that lowers my combat output and my industrial output. Forward, boys! At the double quick! At the double quick. Jeez, this guy's taking heavy losses. Where's 3rd Division? Move them up. I'm gonna have 3rd Division start taking places here. Yeah, you see they broke already. I got a thin line. They got a concrete line. I got a thin line. Come on. Didn't I order a double quick? No, you're not. Beautiful. I got the New York State Militia in on it now. Beautiful. I just broke two of their units. At the double quick, boys! Pour it in! Hit Clark's Brigade. Jeez, 2,900 men. Hold on for a second. Hold on. Hold on. I gotta check something out. 2,900 men, and they brought up another Cooper's Brigade. So they brought out 58. 100 men against my. Oh my gosh. I don't even have 2,000. I have 1,500 men against almost 6,000. I want big brigades, not small brigades. This might hurt me. This might hurt me in the long run. So, what I gotta do now. Oh, this is bad. Oh gosh. Oh, well, actually, no, don't. Don't issue it. Oh, whatever. Oh man, this is gonna hurt me in the end. And what you're breaking? And you're idle. Oh no. How are you idle, man? You can't. Want the artillery. I mean, I definitely have terrain on my side here. I just don't know why it's. I guess I'll do something like that. Dang it. This is bad, man. This flank is not gonna hold good. Maybe I can flank them. That's what I'll do, a flank. Now, I'm gonna issue an order to fall back. Yeah, he. I want them to rest. I want them to break. Dude, I need you to engage there. Why are you outflanked? He doesn't listen. This is the second time I'm issuing the same bloody order. Listen to me. Then putting more brigades into action. Shit, I lost 67 men. They're moving two more brigades to this field. Somebody's breaking. Howard's demoralized. Come on, dude. Charge them. 15 casualties. Come on, dude. You gotta freaking charge them. Do not! When I charge them! Come on, charge, 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 charge! Get the commander right on them. I want him to be right at the field. I issued a fracking order. Third time I'm issuing a fracking order, man. I'm getting tired of this. Guys, when I issue charges, I want you to charge. How many troops did you lose? 139? For an artillery battery. Again, why is this happening? Can somebody explain this to me? I don't understand why I issue order, whoever's in charge countermands that order. That's gonna hurt him. You know, when I say charge, they're like walking charge. They're like, I'm gonna charge. You know, like, I understand they're green, but daggone. There we go. That's it. That's the style, Lo! That's the style! Lo, short for Lothario, Leverheart. Alright, I'm done. Like, I issued the same order to the same unit like 5 times. Oh, shoot. Ah, no, no, no. Get him out of the freaking range of fire. You Stunot, come on! Why is the AI not fucking listening to me all the daggone time? Three, four, 5 times I can issue the same order and they still don't do it. Quick, boys! So I lost another brigade. Man, I love the sound effects. This is like overwhelming. I'm gonna have. What the frick? What the heck is this? Is it a Confederate cavalry unit there? Are you serious? Where's my own cavalry? Okay, that's where they are. Okay. Daggone. How the frick did I get a cavalry unit behind my lines? New York State militia is falling apart. You guys broke too. So now we're in like a little weird line here. So it goes like this. I mean, I still have them surrounded. But it's tight. It's tight. It's tight. It's tight. Send a rider over there so I can issue the charge. They're getting flanked. Send a rider there, please. Oh, dang. He's getting shot up. The center of the line is collapsing. Dude, you need to listen to me. Please. A million times I gotta tell him the same thing. Pour it into them, boys. I got 700 men facing four Confederate brigades, a total of dude, like 10,000 men. 700 troops against 10,000. That's a lot. And we don't have no more reserve. This is it. I'm throwing everything I have at them, but it's still not enough. They're tight, man. And I'm losing units. I'm hoping maybe come behind them, the cavalry chews them up a little bit. I don't know. Hurry up, get those cannons, see if you could throw it at them. Hurry up, dude. I don't have much time. It's gonna be nightfall, too. 1655. Ah! Two brigades broke! Oh, this is not good. Not good at all. Shoot. Alright, hold on, hold on. Before I lose half my commanders, I gotta reform the line. And the way I gotta reform it is along here. It's the only thing I could think of. They broke one, two, three divisions. They destroyed three of my divisions. Daggone, man. That's not good. Oh, that's definitely not good. So the only thing I can think of doing is doing a fallback maneuver with these guys, so I'll do that. And then we'll fall back with these boys. Because it's not nobody left. We gotta fall back, man. We have no. The whole freaking three divisions completely destroyed. I'm hoping this battery can hold them with Winfield Scott at its helm. I'm gonna freaking put the army general there. Where's the freaking army general, man? Where's the army general? Where are you hiding? That's 4th Division. Where's the army general, dude? Where the frack did he go? Did he run home? see division HQs. I don't see no army HQ. He must have felt. No, that's where he is. Go shore up Hancock. So I lost 2,400 men. I'm down to 13,000. This is tight, guys. This is tight. I'm losing a unit here. I'm gonna have Thomas's brigade. They got three brigades coming at him. He's about to break. Dang it, I lost! I can't believe I lost! How did I lose, man? Oh man, this sucks. I got 2,200 men holding this hill. He broke. Does anybody reform? Nobody. Everybody's running for the hills. The whole left flank of the army is collapsed. Everybody. And I got like 10,000 Confederates coming along my left flank that's in the air. Dude, this is not good. I don't think we're gonna win this one. I really don't think we're gonna win this. The Confederates. I mean, these three brigades that are coming up are seriously gonna beat the crap out of me. Like, they're gonna come in and hit him with everything he's got. Concentrate on these guys, please. Unbelievable. I can't believe I lost all those divisions. I guess when the Confederates have a division of 10,000 to my 3,000. Oh my gosh, the whole flank is gonna cave in. Do double quick there, please. You need to hold New York, Vermont State Militia. Oh, please hold. Keep them occupied, boys. There they come! I got Williams' brigade is gonna try to shore up the left flank, and I got some cavalry that's gonna try to shore it up as well. If I can push them off this fracking hill, I got the secondary objective. Give them cold steel, boys! Are you? Don't tell me. Oh, you stew nod. I need you. Oh, don't do that. I need you there, dude. Double time. At the double quick. Come on, come on, come on. I guess nobody, nobody, come on. I ordered the charge. They're like, oh, we're not gonna charge. I ordered a cold, man, it's so hard to do these little things. Come on, guys. Please charge. Man, the 2nd Brigade's holding pretty good with those rifles. Wallace, again, I don't understand why I issue an order, they don't do it. And it's not like the commander's fart. He sends the order here. I'm gonna watch while this freaking guy goes. I guess when I watch them, that's when they'll actually do the freaking order. Tight. It's very, very tight. Where's the commander of our army? I lost 2,900 men. And some of the boys are low on ammo. I mean, I got him against the ropes. Like, I can feel him breaking. I gotta keep checking the chat. Quirky Duke, how you doing? How's this? How game? What game? Oh, this is a Grand Tactician, Civil War 1861 to 1865. By the way, is that a Marine Corps account logo? Is that a Marine Corps boot camp photo? Looks very familiar. Mississippi rifles are falling. See if I can get them right up on there. This is the problem right here. This is the problem. This little group right there. Oh, now they charge. Oh, no, they're not charging still. I love having these rifled muskets. I'll tell you, the range on them is beautiful. Keep breaking this unit. If we could break them. They only lost 150 men, supposedly. Do we have any units that are in reserve that reformed? Nobody. Everybody's still broken. And my cavalry guys are low on ammo. Rounds you got left, 39. Concentrate on him. Ooh, it's about to go sunset. Ah! First battery broke, and the 2nd Brigade broke. Daggone. I was hoping to put the cannons right there and just fire right into them, you know? Keep firing. Keep it up, boys. Keep it up. Keep firing into them. Put the general closer. Come on, man. Alt. I guess. No. Right here. Right here. Stew nod. No. What are you doing, you stupid idiots? I hate this guy. I hit alt. I'm trying to get him to go here. He's not listening, the fucking idiot. He just moved all my units, you stew nod. Keep hitting them. Oh, he's breaking. So the line now is just going to be this part here. Jeez, man, it's freaking ridiculous how bad it is. Oh, you're idle. I should probably put you somewhere. You're idle too. Come on. Not far. I don't like firing. Right. 13 rounds. At least I got the Confederates right in this little gully here. Gonna issue a fallback order for this guy. Everybody's low on ammo, huh? Pushing on the ridge now. They're like, finally we got it. Ooh, beautiful. That lit up the night sky, didn't it, huh? Who are you getting flanked by? I got cavalry trying to hold off that many brigades. Again, issuing the same freaking order. You don't listen. Again, you don't freaking li these guys don't listen. I'm so tired of issuing the same fracking order like 1,000 times. I'm telling you, move here. It sends the rider to the unit, and then the unit's like, no. Move here. No. Move here. No. Move here. No. If I keep the camera on them when the freaking guy gets the order, then he'll do it. Like, I don't know if that is that a feature? They're gonna try to hit my flank. Oh, they took my freaking artillery. That's beautiful. And the cavalry broke. Yep. Or disintegrated. I don't even see their unit being. Yeah, I think it disintegrated. Holy crap. When you finally set up, I need you to hit them. Oh, they're coming around my flank. Fire! Oh! I only got like 11 rounds. Oh man, this is bad. He's getting flanked. Move up. Fall back. Jesus, these thousands of men are really freaking sticking it to me. I got everybody else here. Nobody's reformed. Nobody. Everybody's gone. Concentrate on the left flank because they're going to try to flank us. You, sir, just keep hitting them. Redirect the fire. Redirect the fire. Ooh, he has a feud with somebody. That's not good. Thomas, who do you not like? He doesn't like Kawada. Guys, come on, let it hit night already for my boys to relax. We got three brigades against their, what, five? Six? I'll keep my commanders close so I can get those bonuses. Oh, you're reforming. Good. Reform there. And you're... How low? 9 rounds. Come on, let it hit night already. My guys are firing non-stop. Ah, I lost the left... How did you fracking lose so bad? I got artillery. Holy thing holding... Yeah. See, this is what I mean. Like, I issued that order. You guys saw it like a second ago. I issued that fracking order. And then it's just like, no, I'm not doing that. Oh, come on! Oh, crap. That's great. I guess that one artillery did it. Crap. Let's head north. Oh, that's where the Confederates came through. Oh, that's not good. I lost anyway, so I'm not really. At this point, I really don't care. I was so close, man. I don't know how many troops they have. Like, it really bothers me. 17,000. I had 14,000. I could have won it, man. I don't understand. Does that 3,000 men really make that big of a deal? I had better weapons. Have my units, a few of my units had Mississippi rifles. I could shoot a freaking fleet from a mile away. Oh wow, that's actually good. So, Starbucks didn't have iced coffee. So, they had a cold brew. Which, apparently that's what that is. I guess they issue a retreat. Wait. Okay, so I got a bunch of reformed units now, but they won't. That's great. I'm gonna lose these cannons, I bet. Dang Confederates, man. Dang those Confederates! It's like the actual beginning of the Civil War where the Union just couldn't make a win. Alright, finish it off, finish it off. Oh, whoa, whoa! You gotta hold them off, dude. For 1 minute. Zero minutes, come on, flip it. There you go. Withdrawn. Oh man. Alright, so 3,800 men to their 26. Why can't I come out on top? I lost all my guns. Lost all my guns. Oh man, I lost 17 guns. They had 25. I think they lost 5, so they gained 12. So now they have 37 guns to my. Oh man. 3,000. Oh, they had 20,000 men? Crap. That's my 16. I should have still been able to. Ah! Major defeat, too. Major defeat. Our own losses amount to 4,191. Enemies believed to have lost 3,000. Our national morale drops by a whole percent. That's pretty big, considering it was 0.4, 0.3 before. Due to his bad performance, Brigadier General Baker has fallen to disgrace in the eyes of his men. Major defeat. I gotta check the British, the Great Britain and European intervention status. It's probably higher now. Dun, 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 dun. See how bad this is, guys. We lost the entire army. 12,000 men left. And they also had another army down here. Army of the Shenandoah, 13,000. And the Army of the Potomac. They could have had so many troops. Oh my gosh. The war in the freaking area there is so bad, man. It is so bad. It's not even funny. It's bad. Alright, a disaster for the Union. Confederates stand firm. Federal volunteers skedaddle. Holy crap, that's not good. Lincoln calls. Northerners losing heart. Wow. British intervention is still at 10%. It's not bad. National morale is 98 to my 85. National support. Morale of armies. Oh my gosh, I'm at 75. Loyal states, men fielded. They still have more troops than me. 62,000. It took me a while to get 53. Now they got 62. Dude, I gotta issue new policies. How many policies I got going on? I got this guy. How long is this going on for? 66 days. And then I got this one at 72 days. And this one, 41 days. Oh my gosh, man. Guys, this is bad, man. This is seriously, without a doubt, really bad. Man, this is bad. I'm going to remove Patterson from command of the army. He needs to be replaced. I just don't know who. Hooker's wounded. He would have been my next choice. Because despite what you guys think about Hooker, actually, yeah. I was going to say that he had, you know, like, that he attacks. But I remember Chancellorsville. So, no, he doesn't. That is gonna hurt, guys. A lot of my commanders are, like, in really bad shape. Alright, so what I'll do... Who did good? Didn't Howard do good? third division that did that? Second division, I think. Alright, I'm gonna upgrade. He broke, though. That whole division broke. I shouldn't. I want to put somebody in command that's really good. Maybe Kawada. He did pretty good. His leadership is pretty good. I don't know, maybe I should leave Patterson. He looks better than most of them. Son of a gun. I don't know what to do. I guess I gotta replace Wool because he's shot. Literally. Let me first do this. Why is John Gibbon? Why is the AI putting in? I thought John Gibbon was. There we go. Why you put Hancock in place? I don't understand. I'm gonna take Wool out. I'm gonna replace it with Hancock. Griffin, Green, Taylor. Let's do it on the infantry. Find it maybe easier that way. Who's this? Lew Wallace. Ooh. I want Hancock, though. If I could find them. I wish you could search for commanders. You know, that's the next thing that they need to add to this game is search instead of, like, me going down this list. Ooh, Dan Butterfield. Dan Butterfield. Fran Siegel. Everybody's a lieutenant. Jeez, they're like brand new. I got a lot of lieutenants, man. John Reynolds. Oh, yeah. John Reynolds. Why does it say artillery, though? That's weird. Jeez, there's 645. Oh my gosh, dude, I am not sorting fine by. Oh, my bad. There is. Fine by name. Oh, okay, that was easy. There we go. That was easy. Alright. I didn't see that fine by name. Gotta open my eyes. Alright, so I have Hancock in charge, promoted him commander. Ooh, he looks good. Oliver Howard still in command here. Kawada. Franklin didn't do well, so I'm probably going to replace him. Let's see if I can. Reynolds. John Reynolds! Put Reynolds in command of the 1st Division. This is going to be good. Alright, so I got a couple of good commanders now. I'll add a couple of more brigades to his force. All the volunteers just dried up. Guys, this is bad. Dude, I can't even get infantry. Look at this. Look how bad this is. And obviously I can't draft, right? Like, drafting is not. Yeah. Dude, I'm gonna lose a war if I don't do a draft. So I'm gonna go to policies. Where's drafting? So I got that. Where's drafting? I need drafts. military too. Recruitment, bounties, enrollment, enforced control. Oh crap, this is gonna take forever to get. Oh crap, this is gonna take forever to get. I definitely have to get this. It's gonna take 160 days, half a year to get it. Oh, that's bad. Oh, that's so bad. Because this is what I need. This will increase recruitment. I need bodies. Because I at this point, there's no volunteers. Nobody wants to join the army because they're like, dude, everything is bad. This is not good. This is really, really bad. I mean, I've secured Missouri. I think Kansas looks fine, yeah. And all the northern states are good. But the east is where just horrific losses have been. Horrific, horrific losses. At like a level that we've never endured before. See if I can get rid of McDowell. Because McDowell, he has fame, but administration, yeah, he's not that good, man. Seriously, we need to replace him. Still losing men. And they're not going to be ready for action for a long time. 11,000 men. Unbelievable. I wonder how I can increase this level. 83 days. That's not freaking. I wish there was a way to kind of increase the, I'm sure there is, especially with a commander. So since McDowell lost, I'm going to replace him. I just don't know with who. That's the only thing is, Hooker is hurt. I don't know. I don't know. I really don't know. Let's do this. Let's get rid of him. We'll put Wallace in command. And then I'll just upgrade everybody with commanders. Like, I'm going to get rid of Baker. He's... Eh. Sort by... Give me... Leadership. Give me somebody good, or it's good. Let's do him. Yeah, I'm gonna replace you too. French is good. Give me somebody with a name. I want somebody with a name. Ooh, I like you. All right, we'll put Lieutenant. It's amazing they go Lieutenant to Colonel. I gotta replace some of these garbage commanders. Why would the AI give me such garbage commanders? Seriously. Porter, Barry, Norman Hall, Bradley, Martin, Wheeler. Wheeler. Oh gosh, that's horrible. Sedgwick. Let's do him. Right, so Pep French and then McDowell, I'm gonna replace with was his name? Damn, my freaking memory sucks. Jefferson C. Davis. I read about him. Sucks to have the same name. What the heck was that guy's name? Who's leading third division? I forgot the daggone name. You guys gotta act as my memory bank, because daggone. I forgot this guy's name, man. Let me do by experience. Right, so everybody here has experience. So he should pop up here, whoever. Oh, sure. I forgot the guy's name. Damn it. I figured when they were promoted, like the guy was acting colonel. I figure if I get him, I've unassigned him as division commander, he would stay as a division commander, you know? I mean, not division commander, as a colonel. I guess not. Sucks. Oh, that's why it was on the fracking artillery. That's why it was on the fracking artillery. There we go. Wallace. There we go. So it does stay. All right, cool. So I got Wallace now in command of the Army of the United States. Hopefully that does something. Maybe it'll increase it a little bit. No, it actually lowered it. Gotta love it. Oh, son of a. We're just in really bad shape, aren't we? Just really bad shape. Dude, the Confederates can begin the invasion of the North, and we wouldn't be able to about it. One thing I will say is the developers of this game, love you guys. You definitely have improved the AI. Without a doubt. So, props. Thank you. I love challenges like this. So, he's moving the Army of the Potomac back. Huzzah! Huzzah! Gonna take a long time. Let's go to 5X. Is there a hospital somewhere here? I wish these icons would stay there. Let me see if there's an option for that. Cause I don't know what the heck is going on. There's that. So I'm gonna see if there's a option to guess I got everything turned on. See if there's a way to keep I don't want historical fonts. Lock map, no. Deactivate newspaper, game remains. deactivate. There we go. Damn. Okay. I don't see a way to, what do you call it? I know there's a hospital there. I just saw it. There's no hospital here. So guess what? Let's build one. Things that I can't get my readiness up, so he now knows because my readiness is so bad that I'm not gonna be able to counter him there. Readiness is so garbage, man. And provisions are gone. 21 days, come on. Alright, let's go back to Cairo then, since. Your provisions are out too. Union issues bonds, yeah. Unbelievable. Freaking bad stuff going on. Bad mojo. Come on, Wallace. I want to replace some of these commanders. Oh, man. Experience, seniority, no. Ranking, no. Fame. I want people by initiative. Can I do two? No, just one. Ooh, I like you. You're with the infantry, good. Alright. Why can't I use you? Why does it say red? I wonder why. That's weird. Thomas Sherman. Alright, I'll use you. Jeez. Wish I could use him. Charles Hamilton, infantry. Very good. Let's use you. Good. Sherman, good. Morgan, good. Jeez, you stink. Sheridan's infantry? That's weird. If you guys are not familiar, Sheridan is in charge of cavalry during the war. Why are there infantry commanders in charge of artillery? I don't get that. Doesn't make any sense. Artillery. Give me a good guy. Good. Good. Alright. Gosh. Alright, yeah, it's just that, man, some of these guys are in really bad shape. Ah, oh, Kiem, freaking, that could have made the thing, you know, that could have been, like, the deciding factor. Because, honestly, like, it's bad. Why are you in command of infantry? Still Greenhorn. The Russi. Good. That's all right. Ooh, I like that, Summoner. Yeah, you're getting replaced, dude. Go back to your tea and coffee. Oh gosh, you freaking sick. Hatch is fine. Yeah, it's probably the commanders that really were killing me. Steel is fine. Oh, he's gonna be good. Yeah, I feel like the rest of them are good. So it should be good from now. The Army of the Republic will be good. I want to make sure that this army right here is set. So I'm gonna go over all their commanders. I know Keyes is good, Sedgwick's good, Sherman. I figured that would be bigger, but okay, whatever. Why is Sherman in charge of artillery? Come on! Don't do this to. Don't understand that. That's weird. That's weird. Why would Sherman be in charge of artillery? Come on! Oh, that's right. That's fine. I can't believe I'm putting Sherman in. You know what? Colonel Sherman, you're in command of a whole division. Hooah! Can I get a hooah for the first division? Hooah! Right, Hunter. Oh my gosh, you stink, man. I got Burnside there. Man, this is not good. Hunter, you gotta be replaced, man. I need good guys. I need guys that have like double in many things. Give me leadership. Give me leadership. So I put Tidal, and then I'm gonna have. Like you. Well, we know Cedric's good. Ward's good. Wilcox, I'm gonna replace you, my friend. I'm sorry. I don't wanna be a. But I need somebody like Hamilton. Oh gosh, you stink, man. Oh, what is this? Engineer. Ooh, I like him. Bull Nelson. Man, oh man, oh man. I mean, like, I feel like honestly, once I get better these better commanders in these spots, that why is Cap Sykes in command here of artillery? Why is this happening all the time? I don't know why the AI did that. But I'm hoping that once I get people where they need to be, that this is gonna work out well. You know? gosh, like, this could be a reason right here. Like, this guy's all one down the line. He's like old and. Oh, there's POW. They can capture guys. Interesting. Come on, give me somebody good, guys. Come on. McCook's fine. Please tell me he's at least artillery. No, you put another infantry officer in command of artillery. I. Daggone, man. Seriously. Yeah, he's fine. Please tell me. Dude. It's gonna take forever, man. Custer's there. Got King. And then we got Greg, which is good. And then Buford's in command overall. You have an artillery guy leading an infantry. Why is this so weird? Like, I got some brigades that are not even formed. Again, with our officers that. I mean, at least put an infantry guy for infantry. Like, I don't get that, man. Like, I don't understand that. Ooh, this guy has good administration. I don't know what administration does again. I'm assuming something. Come on. Come on, pop up. I see it trying to pop up. There we go. Good administrator. Have ammunition. Okay, so that's what. So that's what administration will do. And then leadership. And then initiative. So I'm assuming administration will have something to do with getting my guys, more readiness. That's what I'm guessing. That's what I'm guessing here. Come on, dude. I don't care about your fame, dude. Seriously, I do not care about your fame. They're fine, though. Is this another artillery? No, infantry. Good. Infantry. Infantry. Gosh, you suck. I don't know why I have to keep selecting that. It normally did. Oh, was that Reynolds? No. Again. There's no majors in the US Army. Oh, I like you. All right, I think I'm good to go there. I'm hoping this helps a lot. My readiness is worse. I guess when you change commanders, that's the thing. Your readiness goes down, but it's worth it in the long run, you know? Worst thing you can have is. Army led by commanders that are garbage. And I should have done that beforehand. Jeez, he's down to 8,000 now. Is that like. Wow, that's bad. 5,800 men. Jeez. That's a lot of men hurt. A lot of men hurt. Shoot. This is freaking bad, man. Supply alerts. Your mother's uncle. Enemy blockades. Cape May and Abbey is something. You guys don't have money, food, nothing. Oh, your mother's uncle is not a good person. 4 days for that hospital to come out. Why'd you stop in Baltimore? Keep going. Oh, because you're. Oh, that's cool. Check this out, guys. So when an army is on one track, the other army has to wait until that army passes. That is actually cool. And I'm moving them around for the purpose being is because there's a hospital here. I can get that 5,600 down quickly. And of course that this army is a good 2,900 men. 29,000, sorry. Jesus, army's at 10,000. And then this way, I can get that down quickly. Finally got provisions. These guys finally got some food. Once these are built, these supply depots. Maybe I'll start advancing. See, he's going back. How many troops you got? 5,000 and how many? 17,000. All right. It's like a game of like cat and mouse, you know? Man. Let's see if there's any, what do you call it? If I can form up any more brigades. Is anybody interested in joining the Union Army? No, everybody's like, screw that. We're not joining no Union Army. And this is really tight, guys, because I'll tell you why. Because there's no volunteers, which means the Confederacy, which is in a really good spot, they just fielded. Now, they have a lot more men than me, right? So now there's going to be a big gap because nobody wants to join the Union Army. So what's going to happen is, I'm not going to be able to field men. The Confederacy, which won three, four battles, whatever, their morale is high. They're going to have more volunteers, which is going to put me in a disadvantage. So, like, I wish I could just issue the... I hate that I have to do these policies. I just want to issue the draft right now, like, today. What is this? Armored gunboats? I don't want that. Cast artillery. What is this going to do for me? Finance the weapons industry and mass produce simple cast. The non-recursive fissure. Cast bronze can be produced. Give me something good. Reborn muskets. There's no lack of weapons. Many of the weapons are already old and obsolete, including aging weapons and a quick option to acquire a number of rifles or armed to modify. This modified reborn musket are cheap. So, nah, I don't want that crap. Reborn agents, finance recruits, spy on the enemy, and report on troop movements. Ooh, I like that. I could do that. Okay. I'm going to do this. I definitely need that. So. Hopefully now that I did that, I should get more volunteers. Hopefully. Let's see how quickly that... I doubt I'll have them now, but... Let me just see. Has that made any difference right away? I don't think so, no. Jeez, man. Pennsylvania's at 23 guys. They're like, hey, we'll go. And we're like, yeah, guys, we don't have anybody for you. it's your mama. Let me see the artillery, too. How many batteries you guys have? Because I lost a battery, so I need to know how many. I don't know if if they just refilled automatically or what. Doesn't tell me how many batteries they got. Alright, we'll replenish three brigades since they can't even do anything. He's almost at a next level of. Weather's bad. 25,000 soldiers now! Oh my gosh, dude. Maybe two armies combined. 25,000, so we're equal. Fill up those troops, please. See if I can. Oh, I got more Springfield muskets. I'm gonna upgrade my boys. Let me put them on the Sherman, actually. Rifled musket. Rifled. Change you up. More guns. More good guns. So that's good stuff. All right. 31,000 men. I got 1,000 that are. I got 26 barrels. He only has 7 guns. Jeez, my gosh. Because he has 4 and he probably has 3. That's why. How many guns, projection wise, how many guns does this army have? 10. I doubt that. So I guess we just gotta wait. I'll do 20 times. The troops gotta be there. I figure they would lift a contingent behind. Shit. Why is there like a skull crossbones? That usually means that. Come on. Oh, damn, I did. Did it click already? Oh, shh. Oh, I'm not having a good day. All right. That's probably why the depot is not there. What? Treaty with... Oh, okay. Okay. Whoa. I don't even... freaking check that.
So I got the first fleet here. How many ships you got? Two. I'm gonna head up to New Haven. Apparently, oh, there's a fracking. Why isn't it on the main screen here? I guess there was. I just didn't see it. Get up there quick. Daggone freaking Confederates are blockading my ports. They're doing the reverse, man. That is not cool. That is not cool. Alright. So, let me get the second fleet. We got a. I should have been doing this in the beginning. Let's head here. 10 out of 42. We're going to start blockading their ports. I should have been doing this in the beginning, but stupidity. Or just impatience, I don't know. Let's blockade Savannah. They got 84,000 men fielded, 20,000 more troops than me. And I don't think I got any more volunteers ready to join the army, so not good. So now we're in a defensive mode because I still don't have any volunteers. Look at this. I got 1,200 from Kentucky, so 100 troops more than last time. I don't know how to get it up. Like, I really don't. Like, this is 135 days. Maybe if I initiate. No, it's not gonna really do much. Ah! Can't believe this crap. I'm in a really bad spot here as the Union. Really bad spot. British intervention still at 10%. Man. Like, I'm in a bad spot. Like, if the Confederates want to invade the North, they probably could at this point. Men. My gosh, dude. Please, people. Can I give, like, hold on. I know there's a way. Hold on. I know there's a way to, like, increase bounties. You know what I'm saying? Like, give people more money to join the army. I know there's a way to do that, I think. And hopefully that increases the amount of people joining the Union Army. Because right now, oh crap, 56, well, that's because I'm redoing a couple of brigades, divisions. Morale went up. Taxes up, policies, projects. It's not going to be here. It's not going to be in goods and trade. I mean, the only place I could think of it is in the military. So if I hit this, right, let's take Pennsylvania, right? There's no, I don't see anything that would increase the amount of volunteers. Recruitment cost. And obviously, I can't do drafts because we're not doing drafts yet. I don't see anything I can increase the salary. Like, that's one thing that maybe they could add in the game, which I would really appreciate, is the fact that be like, hey, listen, guys, we'll offer you the standard pay plus $1,000, whatever, to join the Union Army. But I don't see that, a way to do that, honestly. I didn't do that. All right, good. So I got how many ships engaging in this Battle of Long Island Sound? I got 11 ships to their 5. And none of them are, what do you call it? You know, like the Monitor or the Merrimack. So naval firepower outweighs them by leaps and bounds. If I could sink that Confederate fleet. Yeah! All enemy ships escaped, though. That's bad. Oh, wait. There was a Battle of the Lent. Oh, that's good. Very good. One ship has been sunk, 2 ships captured. The condition of the enemy fleet is to be alarming. Very good. Very good job, Admiral. Very good job. You get a promotion for doing that. Whoa. What you had here? First fleet, flying flotilla, Atlantic blockade, Gulf blockading, second fleet. No, I don't want to construct a new ship. No. Okay, there we go. How many ships do I got? I got enough. Alright, so once the third fleet is ready to go, I don't think she is though, but when she's ready to go, I'm gonna start blockading. Where do the Confederates get their stuff? I have that. Oh, crap. Low readiness. I hate the readiness thing. That gun. KC at destination. Alright. Let's build a Dagon supply depot. There's a supply depot there. Continue building that. 35 days. I don't know what the frack to do anymore with this thing, man. I'm in a really bad spot. Like I don't, I honestly don't know. I'm in a really bad spot. 'Cause I wish they had the thing where you can give people extra money to join the military, like volunteers, you know? And I wish you didn't have to do a draft, like do a policy to get the policy to do a draft. I guess it's probably the first time in American history, so I guess that's probably why. That's not good, because that means they're gonna get a lot more troops than me. Like, look at this, already 85,000. I got a fleet here, 7 ships, but they're all disabled, so that's good. Oh, come on. My guys are stuck. Go right here. Oh, crap. That's why. And there's a fort there. I see what's going on. Oh, wow. Okay. I didn't know that fleet was whatever. So I got 69 men holding that fracking fort. And I got this little Wilmington fleet heading up. I got a Savannah squadron through. Oh, gosh, man. When are you ready? Guess he's not moving. Seriously, Farragut. How we doing here? Out of range, low ammunition, low ammunition. Oh no! I lost the ship from that fracking fort. Break it up. I have all these guns bombing that fracking fort. I can't issue them to. Oh, I can. All right, let me get the frack out of Dodge. See if I can go out in the open water. Shoot. I'm hoping that they're not kind of limited. All right. This is not good. Economy alerts, supply alerts. What? I don't know, guys. What do you guys think? I'm just kind of like spitballing here. I'm in a bad spot. Oh, they're bringing up more ships. They got a Wilmington. That's the same fracking fleet. Do me a favor, since you got really hurt badly, head back home. Lost the ship. I got the second fleet here. Let's head over here. Come on. Oh, there we go. Ship sunk, the CSS Ellis. So they got a North Carolina squadron. Ooh, don't go that fast. Four enemy ships sunk. Very good. I like that. All right. Yeah, go slow. Go slow, dude. All right. So they still got two ships left. I'm sinking whole Confederate Navy. Maybe I could actually have some good news from the sea, you know? To kind of coordinate with the losses that I'm taking on the freaking... Yeah, Wilmington squadron there. The losses that I'm taking freaking on the land. Are you blockading Wilmington? Let's see if I get closer in. I got one ship being under fire. That garrison, we gotta eliminate it. Fort Castle, right? Yeah. I mean, I have more firepower than this fracking fort. Alright, what we'll do is this. We'll continue firing. I'll let it go for like a day. They're at 91. Oh, no, they're going down fast. Okay. If I could get rid of that fort, I'm going to do that. Start rocking these forts, you know what I'm saying? That's why I could start blockading. Oh, no, 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 no. You're not doing that. See what it's going to do? It's going to go down this pike here for this wrecking Fort Macon. So you're going to go this way. Like nothing. I guess 1861 is you know, gonna be a slow year. Bill to preserve the Union. No action against slavery. Bill passes almost unanimously. Thaddeus Stevens abstains from voting. Oh, I got something here. Cast artillery. Give me something good. Give me something good. Reborn muskets. I'm not doing that. Recruit agents. No, I don't want to do that. Trade warfare. I don't know. What do you guys think about this? Each level of this project further increases the effectiveness of the blockades. Or I could do recruit agents. Wish I could do more of this. I'm gonna wait until I can get more recruitment officers. I need more of that. Oh, hello. Hello, sweetheart. Where are you going? You're going north. Oh, I can't allow that, my friend. See, hopeful if I can catch up with him. I'm gonna try to freaking. Oh, who the heck got hurt? Come on! Go, go, go! How we doing? Oh, go slow, go slow, go slow. 36%. My ship's doing good. Some are in kind of shape. But it's okay. He's gonna try to freaking blockade again. I don't believe this guy. Is the Third Fleet ready? Good enough. Let's intercept that Frecker. So I can send the First Fleet. Do me a favor, head to Baltimore. Since at this point, you need to reload. On provisions and fuel. Mobile base squadron, 23 guns, and I got 109 to 5. Might be a little bit of disparity there for the Confederates. Funding one policy. Yes! All right, more focus on the Union economy. Printing new notes made available to tariffs. Okay, so that's good. So that's going to help me out policy-wise. Private notes. So I got that one. Tariff Act. I don't want that. Bread basket. How long? 77 days for that military one. Supply efficiency of armies operating in enemy states plus 15%. That should be good, I think, right? How we doing? How we doing? 8,000 men. Jeez, guys, come on, get your stuff together. Form these brigades, let's go. I didn't think it was gonna take that long. Freaking replenishment, I figured it was gonna be one, two, three. 19%, good. I want this freaking Cashwell destroyed, and I'm gonna freaking blockade that port. There we go. All right, 174 guns. I already sinked the CSS General Clinch. And all the crap, the rest of their crap ships are gonna go on the freaking ocean. Phoenix is gone. Nice. Four enemy ships sunk. Navy's not gonna have a problem with volunteers. Keep sinking them, boys. Break them. Break them low. Oh. You're really gonna engage me there? Seriously? Come on, engage them. How we doing? Some ships took some damage. Damn, the Alabama took heavy damage. She's a ship of a line, too. Come on, break that fort apart. They only got four men there. Probably on one cannon. Left. Oh, boy. Oh. How we doing? Come on, build these supply depots already. Come on, it takes like an hour and a half to build them. It's ridiculous. What? Should last economic. What? Shoot, morale of Confederate armies at 98%. With plus 3 recently. Jeez. I got all these ships engaging. Oh, because of low readiness. Ay, chamama. What the heck is this? Unbelievable. I didn't see that. Where did that come from? Oh. So they invaded through Kentucky. Son of a fracker. Projection shows 6,500 men. So they had to invade through Kentucky. I wasn't looking at this because I figured it was still neutral. I guess not. You have this army at 31,000. Jeez. That's great. How we doing? Please tell me you took that bloody fort. Good. Fort's destroyed. Alright, let's head up here. Let's start blocking procedures. Because I know Wilmington's a pretty big port. I got Charleston there. Savannah. He's a good commander, too. Alright. So we got that. I'm assuming just by them being there. Patrol blockade. There we go. Okay, good. Very good. So now I'm blockading Wilmington, which is good. Very good. Very good. Continue to blockade. All right. So, intelligence reports show that there is a Confederate army, but they're heading north. Last it shows.
Dang it. It's daggone not good.
So, all right, I wanna finish up, guys, because I've been playing for a bit. So, this is what I guess my next campaign is gonna look like. Since I can't get any kind of funding for recruitment officers. So I'm going to do more of that. Hopefully I can get more volunteers into the army. The Confederates are 86,000, okay. So what I'm planning to do is this. I'm thinking about stripping the Army of the United States with maybe like stripping maybe one division out. And then putting them here on boats. And then we'll take Wilmington, right? We'll build a fort there, hold a contingent. And then we'll move some, form a new division down the road. We'll do the same thing with Charleston and Savannah. And the hope with this is that 20,000 troops that they have as surplus, well, difference of mine, that they're going to have to send south to guard those, either take those cities, siege them, or whatever, right? That's what I'm hoping will level the playing field. And then with my additional recruiting officers, hoping that will make the difference. But you can see here, they already did an invasion of the north. So now I'm going to move my forces into Kentucky since they violated neutrality. All right. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Union's not doing well. That's for daggone sure. I love this game, though. This is by far the best Civil War game I've ever played in my life.